Let me turn that down. Ladies and gentlemen, what is up? Welcome to the Xbox Bethesda Square Enix WB Games and More E3 Showcase Conference. Hopefully it's not too loud. Probably is. Let me turn it down just a little bit. Should be able to hear me in the game still. So I'm doing this live so I don't have to do like a recap later on. So I want to do these live. You know, we only do genuine reactions here, so don't expect me to be over the top like most of these people that be acting like they be so surprised. But I do want to, you know, make this genuine. And this looks like something like, what you call them, it looks like Persona something, but hopefully it's not anything Persona related. Guardians of the Galaxy? Is that okay? So this is from the same people that made the Avengers game. Same ones that made the Marvel's Avengers game. This is dope. And forgive me if you can hear the fan in the background. I got to keep my laptop cool because it's old as shit. I don't sweat. I drip skills. Merch plug. Link in the channel banner. Teespring stores. Marvel Guardians of the Galaxy. So, same people that made the Marvel game. Looks good. October 20. Oh, this year. Okay, so they not playing. Another thing, I don't mean to talk over him, but I want you should be able to hear me. He's still good. But yeah, the reason why I'm doing this live, another thing I just wanted to mention is so, one, I don't have to go back and do a recap. Two, you can get a genuine reaction. And three, even though I may get copyrighted for the trailers and things like that, which is very likely possible as sensitive as YouTube is, I think it's just the I think it's just a better option to go with. Consequences be damned. I like this explanation, though. They take it forever, but... Oh, and from what it looks like, this is going to be split into several different parts, so I just wanted to say that. Because this is like putting... Bethesda, Square Enix, WB Games, and all those is in this one stream. So I'm only doing the showcases. I'm not doing like the after talks and all of that. Oh, this is gonna be cool. The game actually looked cool. Check this real quick, make sure I'm not going too ahead. I know this whole thing ain't just Guardians of the Galaxy. That's what it's looking like. I'm gonna be disappointed if it is. I wanna know how come they're not letting you actually like play with the other characters. Because games that normally have these where you're controlling one character and you have to like use the other ones as support, it's kind of difficult because sometimes they're not as responsive as as you need them to be. So I'm hoping that they're very responsive. Don't even look like he damaged him. Oh. I know this whole thing cannot be about this one game. This is a 9-hour stream. Okay, thank you. Trying to show us a demo, or are they just trying to show us a trailer? Okay. Cool. The Guardians of the Galaxy damn near took up all the time. They're gonna fret. I ain't played too many Final Fantasy games, but they better do this justice. Final Fantasy 3, Final Fantasy 4, 5, 6, Steam and mobile. Alright, whatever. If it ain't for console, nobody really gives a damn. Now this is the game right here everybody's looking forward to. Because I played this. Legends of Mana. I played this on the PS1. My cousin had this game. I never got a chance to beat it, but I definitely want to get my hands on this and play it. This is one of those games that got my attention for real. It's coming out this month too. Operation Planet Hawkeye. Planet Hulk, I mean. Wasteland Patrol. So Cosmic Cube, Wasteland Patrol. That's another one. That's World War Hulk. Not World War Hulk, but Old Man Hulk. War for Wakanda. They better do Chad some justice, man. It's an expansion. It's not just a included at no additional cost. That's dope. Mobile players. I mean, it's good they're giving something to the mobile, but still, this Hitman. It's Hitman. And that's a mobile game? Why would they make that a mobile game? That would be perfect for the console. They're making some stupid titles for the... It's stupid to make some of those for just mobile, man. Unless they really just didn't think that they were gonna do any good on console, which I don't see how. I don't know. Kindness that remedies strength, whatever the hell that went by too fast. Couple new Final Fantasy titles. Brave Evixius. What's this? Final Fantasy? Looks like... Final Fantasy VII, The First Soldier. Available worldwide for iOS and Android 2021. I know this ain't for mobile. Is it? And again, this is supposed to be a hopefully this is not a mobile game. It looks like it'll be difficult to play that mobile. PS4, okay, good. PS4, see, that's reasonable. I was finna say, I know they're not finna make that a damn. I know they wasn't finna make that just a mobile game. Bro, they really right here trying to sell you on the concept of the game when I'm already sold. Like, people are already sold. All they want to see was the gameplay. You ain't got to sit here and talk to them about it. That dodge was cool. Character designer. Oh, it's a reintroduction, so this is a remake of sorts. I never heard of it before, so this is new to me. But I'm not knocking it, it look cool. Okay, and they gotta close better. Oh, Life is Strange. You know, I didn't even play the other one after the original. Right, I love that game. Life is Strange was amazing. I actually love that game. Hands down, one of the best games ever. A remaster ain't too bad. Don't look like too much of an improvement. I can tell the difference, but remember this whole thing. I need to play that new one where the kid was a superhero. Got a weird head. Why your head look like Stewie from Family Guy? Nah, but she's responsible for the music. She absolutely did a good job. Kid was a superhero. They ain't doing nothing with that. He look beat up. this month. That's cool. Who the hell wants to pre-order a game that many months out? That's September. It's 3 months away. You can wait 3 months. I wonder when I'm going to reveal Deep Nexus. Or is this it? Oh, it's from Team Ninja. So, okay, seeing Team Ninja just got me hyped. Is this Devil May Cry? It's not Devil May Cry, is it? This hack and slash stuff getting repetitive. I could feel the repetition just through this. Oh, that's crazy. Wait, this is Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy. Stranger of Paradise. Final Fantasy Origin. Looks like a dope game. Coming 2022. Wow. Demo available soon on PS5. Damn. Final Fantasy Remake Integrate. And then Replicants, Boring Ass Outriders. The World Ends With You. Now that's a game I gotta try. I played the one on Nintendo DS years ago. I never beat it though. Forspoken. That game got released? Forspoken? I don't know. You can't play that now. That's not even available. So that was the Square Enix E3 conference. It was decent. I think they spent a little bit too much time on Guardians of the Galaxy. Even though it looked dope, it looked like the same. At first I thought it was the same team, but it looked like the same people that made that game. At least they were inspired by what they did with Marvel's Avengers. What other game caught my attention? The Final Fantasy game looked dope, but it looks. Hopefully, the game is the story is able to captivate people, and it doesn't get so repetitive and boring with the hack and slash ordeal. Because I feel like that's the part that's really gonna make people like not wanna. That's what's gonna make it boring in some cases. Life is Strange, of course, the remaster looks beautiful. As they can make it, that is. But True Colors just look like that must-play game. It just looks like the must-play game. I like the expansions and the updates they did with Avengers. So that's always a good thing. The Babylon's Fall looks good. Even for the mobile games. You know, all the Final Fantasy mobile games they made. And everything else they did. It looks cool. You know, I can't really be too mad at that. But overall, I think it was a decent showcase. I don't think they did the best thing that they could. It looked like they were trying to fill time with the developer interviews and things like that, which is cool, but you don't want to spend so much time because people only care about the games. Show us the games, give us a release date, we're good. But most definitely, I will say that they did an okay job with it, and some of the stuff I am looking forward to. So that was the Bethesda, the Square Enix live stream. So I'll see you guys for the next one.